next game because a little bit of confidence is restored midweek. Got me my parlay up as well. Juve minus 120. For a lot of people, that is a simple. Do not complicate it now that Vlahovic is back. Di Maria, Alex's cousin. Well, Alex's cousin, Kostic, who's been one of the worst players to ever put a Juve shirt on, finally scored midweek. Fiorentina. Plus,
when I see that, really upset with me because I don't think he's
Who gets upset with you with that?
Whenever I say that, I think Kostic is a good player, but I don't think he's a Juve level player. You know?
No, he's not. No.
Well, how many players in this Juve squad are Juve level?
Yeah, we're going to come on to that. Let me just give out. Yes, it's a good argument. It's a good argument, and we're all going to agree. Fiorentina at plus 340. Draw is at plus 265. The under over set at 2.5 with the over at plus 105. Mean Ron, coming to you first. First of all, let's talk about Juve just to score twice is plus 100. I'm taking that and running because all of a sudden I have a Juve side at home that has a goal scorer that doesn't come out of the whip for the goals, which then means the midfield, it simplifies their job.
Well, I think we're lucky because in many ways, I do like Miretti, don't get me wrong. I think he's a good midfielder, but I don't think he's the best. And I think Fagioli makes a difference. So I'm glad that he'll probably start this match because you just saw against Salernitana when Fagioli comes on and how much it facilitates the way that the midfield moves, especially now Locatelli has seemingly found his position. And I feel like it's important for them to have that. So Chiesa is a wonder card. And then you've got Vlahovic now scoring. And he was in tremendous form against... To be honest with you, I'm going to be honest. Since Vlahovic has arrived, I haven't been that impressed with his movement or the way that he's been playing the game. The first time, I can honestly tell you, against Salernitana, I thought, finally, I was seeing the Vlahovic that I saw at Fiorentina. So if he maintains that, and even Allegri saying that he's never seen him play like this, or he's never seen him move like this, but he was hungry... He is happy with Di Maria. They're neighbours. They live next to each other. They've developed an understanding. And Chiesa is a wild card. I think this should be a win for Juventus, especially because Fiorentina are having... They struggle away from home, let's be honest with you. And with Jovic up front, I never know what I'm expecting. So having said that, Juve's defence, even though it's only 17 goals conceded, the second best defence in Serie A, it hasn't looked very good recently. So Fiorentina have a chance to obviously score this, but I do think that Juventus can score twice. I don't trust that defence at the back. And Cuadrado is available. But for me, if Rabiot plays, which is likely to, because he did get injured and they weren't sure because he's been training separately. But him with Locatelli and Fagioli in the midfield, I think it's good enough to defeat Fiorentina at least 2-0.
Yeah, midfield continuity, I think, also played a part in Vlahovic. Not getting the service, not the creation, rubbish.
His movement has been, I'll be honest with you, I thought Milik moved a lot better in the beginning. Yeah. I don't think Milik was really anywhere near as talented as Vlahovic, but his movement to the beginning was irritating because he was just pointing as to where
because
he wants the ball.
Because he doesn't know where they're going. That's the continuity of the midfield because
You need to sacrifice yourself. You need to come back and start to play a little bit deeper. But he stays up top and just gets frustrated. So it was annoying for me.
Yeah, well, now it's not going to get annoying because now the midfielders just have to put it into an area and he will then go and finish it for you. And you can enjoy Juve winning this game and scoring a minimum of 2. Alex, you know Kostic, family member. Obviously one of your favourite players while he was in the Bundesliga. What was his problem? Because I've never seen Kostic get the ball and go backwards so many times and run up blind alleys.
Yeah, I think that his problem is the time to adapt at a new in a new country, new style, a better team in terms of quality and history. Hearing Mina saying that Vlahovic was amazing against Salernitana, and if he could keep that form, I want to see him play like that against better sides.
Who did he used to play for?
A team that is struggling that is fighting for relegation, right? I want to see Vlahovic against Fiorentina, and after that and so on. I want to see him in the European competitions playing the same as he did against Salernitana. Of course that he can't do that still, because he just came back and in good form, and we want to see more of him. But I think that the best and the most crucial, the key player in this Juve team will remain Di Maria. I think that Di Maria will remain the crucial player in Juventus squad. If he's fit, he will deliver. His passes, his one-on-ones, he's an absolute brilliant player, and we've seen him everywhere play the same at his highest level. I think that Juventus should win this one at home. I don't know how much this deduction of points affected the team. I don't know how much they will recuperate those points. I don't think so. So it's very important for them to win game by game. Fiorentina are dreadful on the road. I think that they won just two games all season long. But the thing is that they are not conceding a lot of goals on the road. Just 11 in 10 games on the road says enough with their defensive approach. So they would be happier to win a point than to go home with the 3 points. They will never risk on the road. They are a home team. So I think that they will play again very, very solid at the back and try not to concede. I think that normally Juventus should score at least twice. This is why you see that line so high, that price so high for 2 goals for Juventus, because of Fiorentina's back line. But normally, as you said, Juventus should score twice after what we've seen against Salernitana. Again, Fiorentina are not Salernitana.
No, they're not. And hang on a minute, Mina, because Vlahovic used to play for Fiorentina. So there again, how many times has that happened when the old boy goes up against him? He'll be very, very confident.
I think that is a long time ago. I don't think that...
No. Of course, it's still in his blood. But the other one is, Matty's got a pick in this, and it's over 9 corners, which I totally agree with, because now Kostic has just got to get the ball out of his feet, feed it into an area. And what's the area that Vlahovic likes best? It's between him and the goal. Just that in cricket, it's called the corridor of uncertainty. Well, it's exactly the same for them defending defenders. What did you say, Mina?
I was going to say the most common scoreline between these is a 1-0 victory to Juventus. They've played each other 29 times in Turin when Juventus have been at home. Fiorentina have won 3, drawn 5, and I think the rest of all the Juve wins, with the common scoreline being 1-0. So going over 1.5 is probably just on a betting thing. It doesn't happen that often. Juventus don't usually score like a ton of goals against Fiorentina. It's a very grudge match because Fiorentina produced their all against this. If there's a team in the world that they hate the most, it is Juventus. So just in that terms, they will do everything to try to make sure that it's not a thorough beating. So it could be under 2.5 at -125. If you find enough value in that, I would go for that as well.
Yeah, and also, Ash says it's very important, Juve and under 3.5 at +145. Do we see 4 goals?
No, we don't. What Maverick says, I feel like Juventus' mindset changed after points deduction. So they are more free. They have the liberty of going in, all in. I think that it will be a change in the system a little bit. I think that they will try more things for the next season, you know. So I think that this end of the season is a great preparation for Juventus for the next season, you know.
Okay, listen, we've got to crack on. We've got to crack on because I've got a home to go to on Saturday. It's like unbelievable, you know what I mean? Okay, let's have a little look at the official picks, please. And remember, Matty's got one as well. It's 9 to 11 corners in the game at +160. Remember, Matty's gone over 9 corners. I think it was like -120. But Barca Man saying, I think it's -104, +104 for over 9.5 corners. Alex, you left it alone. I've gone with Juve team total over 1.5 at +100. And remember, in the chat, you can have Juve and under 3.5 goals at +145 as well. We seem to like them.